unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Well, here we are at the beginning of another week. I'd like to read for you from Hebrews chapter 2, verses 8 and 9. For in that God put all things in subjection under him, he left nothing that is not put under him. But we do not yet see all things put under him, but we see Jesus, who was made for a little while lower than the angels, for the suffering of death, now crowned with glory and honor, that he, by the grace of God, might taste death for everyone. I hate to wait. Anyone who knows me will tell you that. My driving motto is, keep the wheels turning, baby. My uncle called me Speedy as a little kid because I always ran everywhere. Hey, why walk when you can run? Few words could create more angst in my soul as a kid than hearing, not yet. But God delights in patient plodding. He took 6 days to make the universe. He took thousands of years to bring his beloved Son into the world, and thousands more on the road to fulfill his promise in Genesis 1 and Psalm 8. God's effective workers must learn the value of waiting. All the promises are not yet fulfilled. Hebrews 2:8, we do not yet see all things put under him. God's judgment has not yet been fully executed. As God said in Genesis 15:16, but in the fourth generation they will return here, for the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet complete. All truth has not yet been perceived, as Jesus said to the disciples in Matthew 15:17. Do you not yet understand? Everything is not yet ready. John 2:4, Jesus said, my hour has not yet come. Jesus waited patiently. The battle against sin is not yet won in our own hearts. Hebrews 12:4 says, you have not yet resisted sin to the point of shedding your own blood. The battle continues. And knowledge has not yet been fully given. 1 John 3:2 says, it has not yet been revealed what we will be like, but we know that when Jesus appears, we'll be like him. It's not yet been revealed what it will be when we're like him. Of all the ways we get ourselves into trouble, failing to accept the not yet aspects of God's plan is high on the list. How long is a question asked over 50 times in the Bible, often expressed in prayers of exasperation as God's people face inexplicable frustration at God's seeming slowness. Not yet is hard to accept when we know that at last would fulfill all of our longings. Still waiting. Still waiting for God's plan to come to its conclusion. So let's go back to Hebrews. This letter was written to people who are much like us, people who wonder why a loving God waits so long to deliver, to judge, to answer our prayers. To such painful confusion, the author of Hebrews does not give us flippant answers, but instead points us to consider Jesus himself. We see not yet all things put right, but we see Jesus, who after the cross is now crowned as King forever. You can wait. We see not yet all our prayers answered, but we see Jesus, who after the cross is our great high priest at the right hand of the Father forever. You can wait. We see not yet all our suffering over, but we see Jesus, who after the cross is seated on his throne, preparing a place for us, and will soon wipe every tear from our eyes. We can wait. Remember, not yet doesn't mean not ever. Not yet doesn't mean not ever. Isaiah 46:10, God says, I declare the end from the beginning. Much that God has promised, we do not yet see, but we do see Jesus, our forerunner, our redeemer, our priest, our sanctifier, our elder brother, our captain, our king, crowned and glorified. Take heart. Fix your eyes on Jesus, the one who has waited and waits still until that day when the most glorious statement of all will come from his holy lips. It is done. Every prayer answered, every promise fulfilled, every sin punished, every wrong righted, every grave opened, every accusation silenced, every hurt healed, every tear dried, every question answered. Never again will we hear the words, not yet. Lord, you waited so long, endured so much, and all for us. Give us your grace to accept the not yet of today without losing faith or hope that in your time, your promise will be fulfilled and your purpose will prevail. We ask in the name of the one who has waited longer than time itself, our wonderful Savior. Amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet.